welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be about the hashtag strategy for Instagram in 2020. I also have another video. It's about how to become an Instagram influencer from scratch in 2020. In case you haven't watched it, this is the link. And if you don't follow me on Instagram, my Instagram handle is TheAutomaticDiva. Do follow me. So let's begin. Okay, so I'm going to be telling you a ninja trick to help you grow your Instagram profile towards the end of this video. In case you want to know it, make sure that you keep watching the entire video. This ninja trick has really helped me throughout the last 6 months. And I hope it helps you too. Let's begin. Okay, so moving on to the first point, which is the right hashtag pool that you should be using for your account. If you're a smaller account, make sure that you use 20 to 25 hashtags. And if you're a bigger account, make sure that you use 11 to 12 hashtags, which are optimal for your own account sizes. Try not completely using the entire hashtag 30 limit of Instagram, because Instagram sometimes feels that you are basically spamming the picture. So make sure that you're always using a little bit less than 30. That's the first point. The second point I feel is that make sure that you do your research completely properly. So putting a percentage of hashtags that you should be using here in the groups of the number of posts made on that hashtag. So for example, every time you go on Instagram and you search it in the box, hashtag fashion blogger, for example, it will show you the amount of posts that are done on that hashtag. And if you're a smaller account, it gets very, very difficult for a smaller account to rank on a hashtag which has about 1 million posts. So if you're a smaller account, make sure that you always use hashtags that have low competition. The maximum amount of hashtags that you use should be between 5,000 posts, 300,000 posts, that is like 5,000 to 3 lakh posts. And also make sure that you kind of figure out what the average likes on the post is. That's the easiest way to rank. If you're actually using a hashtag, for example, Indian fashion blogger, and it has 5,000 posts in it and the average likes is 200, you usually get 300 likes on your post. So it's easier for you to rank on that hashtag as compared to the hashtag which is like 50 million posts and the average likes on that hashtag is 14,000 or something. So make sure that you completely optimize your hashtag strategy. 2-3 of the softwares that I use for hashtags is FlickTech. I will link it down below and I will also put a picture up here. They basically show you all the hashtags related to what you search for in the box, and they also show you the volume of posts on that hashtag as well as the average like on that hashtag. So you can actually make a group of hashtags using that website and use it over and over again in a couple of your posts to check if it actually works for you or not. If it does work for you, well and good. If it doesn't work for you, you need to keep switching your hashtag groups. I feel for a smaller account, you should always try to rank on hashtags that have fewer media posts than hashtags that have huge media posts. So make sure that if you're using 25 hashtags, at least 20 of your hashtags are in low competition or medium competition at the max, and use one or two, maybe just two hashtags which are huge hashtags which go in millions or something. There's also another app on iPhone and Android which is called Preview, which you can use for making your own hashtag groups. Moving on to the second point, I feel that I've seen a lot of people do the same mistake over and over again. So basically they have the perfect set of hashtags and the hashtag strategy is completely right, but what they do is what hashtags they use are completely unrelated to the post they have. So for example, if you're talking about women empowerment in the caption and your hashtags are completely optimized and all the hashtags that you've used can actually help you rank, but the post that you've made is actually of a girl walking a dog. So for example, you're talking about female empowerment and you have this entire explore page here where people have very related posts about female empowerment and women empowerment, but then suddenly your posts rank and you see in the same hashtag there's a girl walking a dog, people will not open it. Like they're not likely to open it because they feel that this is something they don't relate to. So if somebody, for example me, is searching for something according to a hashtag, for example I'm searching for trending tops, t-shirts, okay, and then you somehow figure out the right hashtags to rank in the top 9 posts of trending tops, and suddenly I see an animal in a post, I'm most likely not to click on that post, because obviously why I searched for that hashtag was because I was looking for trending tops and not for animals. So make sure any hashtag strategy that you use is related to the post that you're making. So anytime anybody comes to me and says my hashtags are not doing well, my pictures are not doing well, I see a lot of these mistakes happening with them. Going to the third part, make sure that you don't spam all your pictures with the same hashtag groups. I have an entire group of hashtags made, which are lists of hashtags, multiple hashtags to be used alternatively in every post, so that I do not look like I'm a robot or a bot spamming Instagram. And also I have to keep checking if one group of hashtags working for me or the other group of hashtags working for me. So do not keep all your eggs in one basket. Make sure that you have lists of hashtags, at least 4 or 5 groups that you keep switching between in different posts and checking what works best for you and what does not. So a lot of people say that their hashtag strategies are amazing. They're ranking in almost all the hashtags, and but they're still not getting engagement. So I feel that people completely forget that if their hashtag strategy is on point, their posts and their quality of content is not very good. So just because you've got the hashtag strategy right does not mean that your content will completely work. Everything is at play here. It's not only the hashtag. Small account, I see a lot of small accounts using 50 million, 350 million, 450 million group of hashtags, which do not make sense at all for a small account, because for a small account to rank on that level of media post is almost impossible. So like for Google and YouTube, keywords are as important as hashtags are for Instagram. So for anybody to actually search you and land on your profile, you have to make sure that all your hashtags are optimized according to your profile size as well as what content you're making. So this is all about hashtags to be used in posts. You can also, by the way, use hashtags in stories. And for stories, the hashtag competition right now is very less. So you can technically just use any big pool of hashtag on your stories and pray for ranking in one of the stories. For example, if you're putting up a song that you've sung about a singer, you can definitely like hashtag their name. For example, I've sung a song about Dua Lipa and I want to hashtag her name, hashtag Dua Lipa. You have a very high chance of ranking in the story of Dua Lipa. You can use up to 10 story hashtags in any story that you put, but make sure again that you always put relatable hashtags and nothing out of the blue. So if some hashtag is trending currently, for example lockdown 4 or Narendra Modi or coronavirus, and you're talking about it, or you are letting people know what is going on, is there some news or there's something that you made about it, you can definitely use that hashtag for people to land up on your story. So I really want to talk about the right kind of hashtag groups that you should be using. So for example, if you're using 25 hashtags, 5 hashtags each should be allotted to one set of category. For example, I'll give you the first 5 hashtags could be very specific and they could be entirely about the post. For example, I have a video about how to style a shirt. So my 5 hashtags would be completely about shirts. And then moving on to the next 5 hashtags. The next 5 hashtags should be about what you're doing in the video, for example, styling. So these 5 hashtags should be low competition and be about styling. Moving on to the next 5. The next 5 hashtags should be about who you are and what you represent. So if you're a fashion blogger, then the rest 5 hashtags should be about fashion bloggers, Indian fashion blogger, Bombay fashion blogger, blogger style, and all of that. Moving on to the next 5 hashtags, if you have a brand name, make sure that your brand name is focused on in your hashtags. You're always using the hashtag that is more specific to your brand name or your username. So the next 5 or at least 2 hashtags should be about personally you, as what you stand for and what your brand name is. You can also use some very highly engaging hashtags. For example, some hashtags which are very generic, but if you do end up ranking on a smaller hashtag, you have a higher chance of ranking on the higher hashtag as well. So you can definitely use the ones that are very, very big and they have large groups of posts, but these should only be 1 or 2 in your hashtag groups. For example, hashtag love has been one of the most used hashtags on Instagram. So the next 5 hashtags could be about your location, and as local as you go, it will be very, very easy for you to rank. for example, if you're in Delhi, you can definitely use something like Delhi Bloggers, Delhi Lifestyle, Delhi Gram, and all of that. Just research very properly and know what hashtag works for your account size. And just don't use any hashtag that you feel you can rank on. It's not intuition, it's all about numbers here. I have another trick that you can use when you are actually trying to grow your account. What you can do is definitely just go on places in Instagram, and I'm gonna attach a screen here. Go on places in Instagram and type in your region or your locality. For example, if I'm in Delhi, I will type in Delhi, India, and I will engage with people who basically do not get a lot of likes and comments. So for example, my target audience is actually girls in the ages of 15 to 35. What I will do is I will actually pick some girl up whose engagement is very low, mostly between 100 to 300 likes or maybe 5 or 10 comments, and make a very authentic real comment on her post related to her post to build a community. And that for somebody whose engagement is pretty low, and if you comment on their post, they'll obviously notice it and they will definitely open your profile to check who is this who's taking a lot of interest in their picture. So I always make sure that I do engage with at least my target audience throughout the day, here and there. But don't spam Instagram, because if you start doing this a lot in a short span of time, Instagram will action block you, and it'll take you at least 24 hours to get out of that action block. So you can only divide this activity over the day. Earlier we could use bots to do this activity, but now Instagram has an artificial intelligence system in place to actually figure out who's using bots and who's not, and then they completely action block you. So make sure that if you're doing this manually, do not make it look like you're a robot, and just do it over the day, and don't do everything within an hour. Don't just spam random like 100 people with comments and likes. Make sure that you do like one like here, one like there, one comment here, one comment there. But also make sure that you're targeting the right kind of audience, the kind of audience that you're looking at. Maybe just go into your competition's profile and look at their followers, and then start engaging with them. That's how Instagram will know this is the kind of audience that you want to attract, and this is the kind of audience that visits your profile, and it will start recommending more such people and people who are related to such audiences to come to your profile and start showing your profile in their suggestions, which makes it easier for you to increase your visibility for sure. So this is another hack of hashtags that I wanted to tell you.